On March 16th, I woke up completely paranoid that film and TV production was never going to come back. And out of that fear and paranoia came an idea.
All right, ready when you are. Ready and go ahead, Lucia.
Marker.
We're behind the scenes right now.
This is generally camera department over here. This is generally props. Here's a few extra costume department pieces.
So social distance is an anthology. So we're telling eight different stories about eight different groups of people, families, spouses, people who are alone.
It was an idea to shoot a remote production about social distance during this time, shot right now, remotely.
So much more effortless, streamlined, fast.
And we're getting full direction from an amazing team.
The show is from the point of view of the Internet of Connected Things, be it your phone or your laptop or your nanny cam.
This is an exciting new way to shoot TV, but how are we going to see this? How are we going to show this? How are we going to motivate the camera to be here in this moment?
We're so used to doing things one way when we make a TV show. What if we could do it where everyone's in isolation?
Well, there was a lot of fear going in because I had no idea what I was going to be up against.
I was excited and exhilarated at first, and then this huge sound cart arrived at my house, like on the back of a huge truck.
What is this? What? How are we doing this?
I knew that I would have to do stuff, but I really wasn't thinking about it as much as just like the role.
We did our own stunts. I don't want to compare it to the Fast or the Furious or Mission Impossible 3 or anything, but I broke my toe.
It was definitely fine print that I did not read. I was concerned.
It's hard too as a director because you have this idea of a vision of what you want to shoot.
I had never directed via Zoom before.
I'm sorry, I forgot I muted myself and I just gave you a whole note.
So that was a huge learning curve.
We would like walk around the apartment and they would be like, okay, let me see what it looks like if you put this chair there. And like move the couch like that and put that lamp up like that.
Yeah, I had to edit how much I asked Mike to do because he was adjusting the picture, doing all this set dressing stuff, then bringing up the props, then setting the camera, and then he had to get into character.
When we set up Guillermo's camera, it took him 8 hours, and then he had to act.
I was like, I'm never gonna be able to do this. You learn a little bit something about yourself.
I wanted to learn and see, like, how does it work when you're doing the lighting and when you have to set up a room and do the sound.
Okay, let me get back in position so I can figure this out again.
The casting process was different in a lot of ways. One being, none of these actors auditioned for us. We would sort of like zero in on somebody who was, you know, in the right location, living with the right person.
Because we could only work with like people who were in the same household, so like for Daphne's character, who is Reina, in real life, we used her husband and her son, who had never acted before.
When Asante and Aize stepped forward and said yes, I was so excited. This father is not acting 24/7 like Asante is. We were blown away.
Wait, what? Like, I had no idea that this is what they were gonna be asking of him, and neither did he, but we, you know, did the best that we can, and I think that, you know, the outcome was pretty good.
I really enjoy shooting with my mom, natural born actress, and even when she helps me with my auditions, like, I got some callbacks, because mama's, and she got some skills.
Peter's son Leo is 4 years old, and to try and direct a four-year-old via Zoom, it was a real challenge. And we had to commit to that challenge.
Hello!
Once we started recording, it became a mechanism where all the actors were supporting each other, the crew were supporting the actors. The actors, a lot of times, were supporting the crew to do it. And it was a beautiful thing to see this whole thing through Zoom.
We can create art almost anywhere. We can still create something wonderful without having the normal circumstances that we work in.
Work will find a way. People find a way to be creative no matter what.
We really want the show to give people hope, but it's also a vehicle that gives us permission to feel our feelings. It's been an intense time, you know, for everybody. Everyone on the planet is going through a really intense time. That's why we lean on stories.
It truly felt like people really using technology in ways that are beautiful and you know, make the world a better place.
Signing off.